In neighboring Kenya, government officials have all been asked to take the vaccine by virtue of decree, and the Kenyan president Uhuru Kenyatta there has ordered a curfew that is getting underway today at midnight in the capital Nairobi and three other counties. I must say, beginning midnight today, nobody will be allowed to move in and out of the capital Nairobi and the counties of Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu, as well as Nakuru. Let's take a look.
President Uhuru Kenyatta has ordered a revision of curfew hours for the five counties from 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. The rest of the country will continue observing the 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. timing. He also ordered the closure of schools and universities, with the exception of students undergoing examinations.
Based on our previous experience, this peak will flatten only by mid-May 2021, which is about 60 days from now. So fellow Kenyans, to avert a national health crisis, and upon the advice of the National Security Council and the Council of Governors, and also in keeping with the recommendations of the National Emergency Response Committee on COVID-19, I today hereby issue the public order number 2 of 2021 on the coronavirus pandemic as follows.
Kenya's president also announced reviewed coronavirus measures 14 days after his last speech on the COVID-19. Uhuru also announced the termination of all movement into and out of five counties of Nairobi, Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu and Nakuru, which is said to be disease-infected areas, effective midnight tonight.
That 70% of Kenya's reported cases of COVID-19 have been recorded in the counties of Nairobi, Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu, and Nakuru. These counties are individually and collectively declared a disease-infected area. That there shall be a cessation of all movement by road, rail, or air into and out of the disease-infected area as one zoned area comprising of the counties of Nairobi, Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu, and Nakuru, effective midnight tonight.
The set of new measures said to avert a national health crisis also involved suspension of nationwide physical learning in all institutions other than for students sitting the Kenya Certificate of Secondary Education examinations and those in medical training institutions. Curfew hours have also been revised to 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. in the zoned areas, but shall remain from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. in other parts of the country, effective midnight.
With respect to education in Kenya, there shall be an immediate suspension of all ongoing physical learning in all our education institutions, including universities and tertiary and vocational colleges, other than for candidates sitting for their examinations and those in medical training institutions until otherwise notified.
The president also announced suspension of places of worship and bars. Restaurants have been directed to offer takeaway services only. This is in the five counties. All gatherings in the said counties have also been suspended.
Gatherings and in-person meetings of whatever nature are suspended within the counties of Nairobi, Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu, and Nakuru until further notice. Physical and in-person, as well as congregational worship in all places of worship in the counties of Nairobi, Kajiado, Machakos, Kiambu, and Nakuru, stands suspended until otherwise notified.
International travel to Kenya shall continue in accordance to set COVID-19 travel guidelines. The third wave has strained Kenya's health facilities, with the country's positivity rate now at 20%. The rate of infection has gone up 10 times between January and March 2021. Rising death rate from COVID-19 is also a concern in the country. Nairobi County accounts to close to 60% of reported cases countrywide. Earlier in the day, President Uhuru Kenyatta directed the entire cabinet and executive office to get the COVID-19 vaccine as the government scales up the rollout exercise. After the national address, the president and the first lady, plus other top government officials, received their jab at